Be still. Stop. Be attentive. A total attention. Neither past nor future. Be with the present moment. Between you and what you listen to, let thoughts, images disappear. Be just pure listening, a whole being, boundless. The divine instrument, observation, alive and crystal clear. You listen and watch, outside and inside yourself. The whole thinking is mute, a tomb-like silence. There are no expectations, no ideal projections. Body and mind, the whole being, in a direct relationship, able to understand any life phenomenon in a certain way, real and profound way, as ephemeral as it may be. Such a simple meeting is pure meditation. Practice this all the time, in every circumstance, start and end with a total silence. The whole being in harmony, in a timeless state. This peace gives you an ever-renewing mind, completely detached from the old, integrating in the present. Psychologically, you are without centre, boundless. You are immensity itself. Able to embrace the eternity of the moment. Through these simple meetings, the old person starts to crumble. A crack appears in the egoic structure. Through it, the accumulated energies start to leak and disappear. They were holding you prisoner from time immemorial. The liberation started thus is continued in time until in the end, when the ego, the sad conditioning, perishes. The spark, the sacred within us, returns to the source. Sooner or later, this is everyone's fate. Total liberation. Here lies the whole secret of knowing oneself. Mystery intertwined with spontaneous action. The only one which transforms and finally liberates the conditioned being from its degrading ego. Always remember that knowledge keeps you prisoner. Be quick to understand its unintelligent nature. Give all your respect to the moment. Meet it with humbleness. Through it, wonders open into the infinite world. Each person carries within themselves a cunning listener, an arrogant intruder, annoying and nagging. Their presence obstructs listening, which is purity, complete understanding, clear serenity. When real listening occurs, the whole being is passive, attentive, perfectly open. Silent, therefore inactive. There are no expectations, nothing to be accomplished. In its wholeness, alert listening. Is it really possible to experience such a state? You will find the answer within yourselves after persistent attempts. Do not despair at any time, for in each of us are written endless possibilities, clear, certain, and precise. entertain no doubts. Put your whole energy into this crucial achievement. Do not reject anything you hear. Encounter everything with an open being. Be one with what you listen to. If what you hear is false, the false does not affect you. It passes you by. It does you no harm. If what you hear is the truth, in that sublime moment, the wall of the little self is pierced. In you, there is a moment of light. By persevering in listening, the old person starts to crumble, and one day, a surprise day, all mysteries are revealed. When the individual is liberated, they attain immensity. The supreme realization, being one with totality. A natural question appears. How does the listener come to exist? How do they create an erroneous way of listening? They are, in fact, a fiction, which appears automatically from the thought processes of the personal self. Notice how the listener becomes self-important and regards the world with disdain and arrogance. Behold, someone is speaking. They immediately barge in, distorting every meaning. Listening stops. When there is a listener who criticizes and accuses, the individual listens to the self and acts through the self. The connection is broken. Each encounter is empty. Thus, it is impossible to reach truth or love. Knowing this, another question follows. How can we escape from its influence? Every time it appears, encounter it with a total attention, without any imaginary purpose. This silent meeting dissolves it totally. What is left is pure listening, integrated in the present. Listening, watching, are not different from one another. They operate the same way in every circumstance of life. To everything that comes from inside, as well as outside, as turbulent reactions, as imaginary forms, just be relaxed. Watch. Listen. in a perfect way. Neither past nor future. With a lucid attention, you encounter truth. There are no memory residues present in this meeting. Psychological emptiness is the gate to infinite love. The calm comes about indirectly. Not by wanting, nor through imagination, but by simply watching the turmoil of the limited ego. It was created throughout time from ancestral residues. Constantly traumatized through ideal impulses. We watch it totally, without any goals. This direct contact brings perfect quietude. Physically and mentally, health is maintained through calmness. Always attentive, without any purpose. We just watch and listen. Calm comes on its own accord. We are integrated into eternity. When love envelops you, there is no possibility of escape. For you are limited. Love is all-encompassing. You, an ego, in ashes. Love is the burning flame. You are a mere fiction. Love is creative essence. Love is beyond time, a timeless structure, a different dimension, existential in itself. Love is harmony, beauty, kindness. Through itself, a master. Always clarity. Love is eternal light, a total attention. Sparkling flashes of divine origin. Love is unity, enough unto itself. It completely fulfills us with its burning presence. There is no chance of being face to face with love. Be honest with yourself. Abandon all hope of meeting sacred love in its reality. Be humble. Disappear completely. Become a nothing. You cannot speak about love, for you cannot meet her this way. When you speak, it's just hollow words. You are merely nourishing your ego self. If you see yourself as you really are, arrogant and proud, silence immediately envelops you. Through it, you become the whole being. Now love is one with boundlessness, where everything is in harmony through a different way. The sacred, the source of existence, affirms that through purity we can destroy the ego and live in unity.